How do you calculate cost of sales? Hi, I'm Jimmy Chang. I've been teaching college math for almost a decade, and we're here to talk about how to calculate cost of sales. There's actually two categories of how to calculate that. One is actually the more straightforward of the two, direct costing, which basically just has you taking the cost of materials and adding it with the cost of labor, and those two are pretty much it, and so that's a pretty straightforward addition problem. But it's not as involved as what's probably more practical and commonplace, and that is what's called absorption costing. Now, it is used in areas such as accounting and agencies such as the Internal Revenue Service, the IRS, uses absorption costing as well. And what that does is it takes the cost of materials, adds it with the cost of labor, but also adds it with the any overhead expenses that are out there, which, as you know, a lot of businesses have overhead. So it is a third major category of cost that's going to be involved. Now, if you take a look, it's a very straightforward addition problem as well, but it gives you a chance to kind of break down what's involved. So let's just say you have materials that cost you $6,000. You have labor that cost you $5,000, and any of the overhead expenses, whether it be, and they can be lease expenses, how much utilities would cost, and any money you had to spend on office expenses. Suppose all that came to be about $3,000. What you basically do from there is just add the three cost expenses together, and as you can see there, $6,000 plus $5,000 plus $3,000 is going to give you $14,000. That's going to give you the true cost of what your expenses are going to be. And once you figure that out, just gather your revenue together and you can figure out what your total profit's going to be. But that's pretty much how you calculate the cost. I'm Jimmy Chang, and that's exactly how you calculate your cost of sales.